In this video, we'll go through how to convert between units. When you try to convert between units, do you struggle to decide between whether to multiply or divide the values? I will share with you a foolproof method in converting between units. It will be your go-to method whenever you need to convert between units like kg to pounds, atm to torr, moles to grams for stoichiometric calculation, cm cubes to liter for volume, and lots more. The foolproof method we will use is called dimensional analysis. You may heard of it go by a different name like unit factor method or factor label method or maybe unit conversion. So what is dimensional analysis? It's a method that is used to convert one unit to another using conversion factors. Well, the best way to explain is through examples. So let's start with our first example. Here we have Maria. She weighs 115 pounds. And the question wants us to find her weight in kg. So that means the question is asking us to convert from pounds to kilogram. Pounds is abbreviated as LB. It's a US system of measurement. Kilogram, on the other hand, is a metric system. We can convert between these two systems of measurement as long as we know what is the relationship between them. So in this case, if you look it up online or in your book, the relationship is 1 kilogram is equals to 2.2 pounds. To perform the conversion, let's start with what we are given, which is 115 pounds. Then we multiply and draw a line across. Now what we're going to do is we're going to use basic algebra to do the conversion. So since we are converting from pounds to kg, that means we want to get rid of pounds. So we'll place pounds, which is LB, on the bottom. And then we'll place kg on the top. That way, we can cancel out pounds like this, and that will leave us with kg. Then next, what we'll do is we'll place in the numbers. So we'll place in 1 in front of kg and 2.2 in front of pounds. Now let's do the math. So we have 115 multiplied by 1 divided by 2.2. That whole thing will give us 52.3 kilograms. Don't forget to include the unit in your final answer. Let's look through how we did that conversion. We started off by writing out the given value along with its given unit, which is pounds. And then we place the given unit at the bottom so that we can cancel them off. Then we place the desired unit on the top. As for the values, we inserted the numbers we got from the relationship between the two units. In fact, this thing 1 kilogram over 2.2 pounds, that is called the conversion factor. Let's try using this same method on a second example. The question is asking us to convert from PSI to KPA. Both are units for pressure, and if we look it up, we'll find that 1 PSI is equals to 6.895 kilopascal. So let's start by writing out what we need to find, which is pressure. And the value that is given, which is 33.5, the unit is PSI. Then we multiply and draw a line across. We place PSI at the bottom because that's the unit we need to get rid of. Now the PSI will cancel off each other. Then we place the unit that we want, which is KPA, on the top. And then finally, we place in the numbers from the conversion factor, which is 1 in front of PSI. And 6.895 in front of KPA. After that, we'll just do the math. So we have 33.5 times 6.895 divided by 1. That will give us 231 KPA. So you might be wondering, for the conversion factor, must the bottom value always be 1? The answer is no. As long as you set it up in a way where the units cancel off, you can plug in any value for the conversion factor. Here's what I mean. So sometimes when you look up the relationship between PSI and KPA, you get something like 1 PSI is equals to 6.895 KPA, right? Well, sometimes if you look it up, you may also get a different values like 0.145 PSI is equals to 1 KPA. In fact, actually these two conversion factors are the same numerically, but you shouldn't take my word for it. So let's solve it together. So we need to find the pressure. Start off with 33.5 PSI. That's what we are given. Multiply, draw a line across, put PSI at the bottom so it cancels off, KPA on the top, and then we place in the value. So now, instead of placing 1 for PSI and 6.895 for KPA, we're going to place in 1 for KPA, and 0.145 for PSI. And that will give us the same answer. See? So it doesn't matter what the conversion factor is, as long as when you set up your solution, your units cancel off. To recap, when converting between units, always start with the value that is given, followed by the unit, and then we multiply and draw a line across. At the bottom of the line, place the unit that is given so they cancel off. At the top of the line, place the desired unit that will give us the final unit, which is what we want. Then we insert in the numbers from the conversion factor. Then you do the math and you'll get the calculated value. You'll always get the conversion right using this method. We went through three examples together. Why don't you try out one on your own? I'll place the answer in the description box. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.